All right, baby. Let's ride. You may have noticed that in my last video, when I went to motostrada in sucat, I didn't stay all that long, and I didn't even shoot any footages of the store or of the bikes. In the previous video, you see me stopping in front of the store, and then all of a sudden I was starting my bike up again and leaving. It's partly because of my, not really partly, but mostly because of my disappointment at that visit. Now don't get me wrong, the bikes that are there looks great. I mean, as quality wise, in terms of what I can see, they look great, man. Yeah. And if I had money to spare, I would buy one or two of those bikes in an instant. Particularly the 250 and 300 cc bikes. They look great. I bet they'd be one heck of fun machines to ride. Yeah. Yeah. But because of my disappointment that the 400NK and the 650NK were not there. They had the 150NK and the 650MT, which is an adventure bike, and I'm not interested in that bike whatsoever. Since they didn't have the two bikes I was interested in, I didn't see any point in shooting anything, in making any footages whatsoever, so I didn't. Plus, when I asked about the 400NK accessories that they may have available, if they have accessories available at all, particularly a lowering kit for the 400NK, just in case that it's too tall for my legs, the sales lady, instead of answering my question, the sales lady says, "Oh, they don't recommend the bike be lowered because it would affect the performance of the bike." That really put me off, man, I must say. Now, I might just be being overly sensitive, but if I ask a question, I want the question to be answered. Don't give me a runaround. If there are no accessories, whether official store accessory or aftermarket accessory, then I appreciate that you just be honest and tell me, and don't give me the runaround like that, man. Of course it would affect the performance, I'm well aware of that. Any changes that you do to a motorcycle other than aesthetics, like say just decoration accessories or side mirror, any changes that you make to the motorcycle will definitely have an effect on the performance of the motorcycle. So don't give me that bullshit, if you'll pardon my French. Don't give me that bullshit about they don't recommend it since it would affect the performance of the bike and all that. It really put me off, man, for some reason. Yeah. I didn't argue the case. I mean, I'm not really one of those guys who would argue for the sake of arguing. I'm not the confrontational sort of guy, or at least I try not to be. It's just bad for your mood. Just stresses you out for basically nothing. Yeah. So instead, I just looked around and left. Now, depending on my mood, I might come back and check out the bikes if and when they are available. I mean, the sales lady says that they are out of stock of the 400NK, that new units are coming in end of November, so December. I might come back, depending on how I feel the matter. But for the time being, the 400NK, the CF motorbikes are off my list for the time being. I'll just stick to my original choices. I'll either be getting the Rebel 500, the Honda Rebel 500, or the Kawasaki Vulcanes. Of course, I've seen this ad on the Facebook page of Kawasaki Leisure Bikes. I think it's the Leisure Bikes Nueva Ecija or something like that. It's not in Metro Manila, but I've seen an ad or a picture of I don't know if it's really a new model, but I'll have to check on that. But it looks like a new model to me, a new model of the Z650. It's a sports version of the Z650. I forget the name. I think it's the Z650R. I have yet to lay my eyes on it on one personally, but from the picture, man, it looks like a great bike. It looks a lot better than the ordinary Z650. And I find myself thinking, I just might go for that. So, now my choices are three bikes. Honda Rebel 500, the Z650R, and the Kawasaki Vulcanes. Yeah. Man, if I do go for the Z650R, it's gonna be quite hilarious, man. Because I have the Z250 SL, I have the Z1000R, and if I get another Z, I'll be a Z collector, basically. Eh. Just call me the Z guy. Zed more. Wrong Wolf Zed. Yeah. But of course, that's still in the future. As I had mentioned before in my previous videos, I'll make my decision come the end of the year. Assuming I have the money for one already, or I've already put enough money together for a new bike. At the moment, I'm still a little bit short. But I'll make my decision by the end of the year, assuming I have the money for it, as I had mentioned. If not, then basically next year. Next year, whenever I have gotten the money already. Yeah. Now you might be wondering, why not buy a bike on terms? I mean, on installment. It's not me. I don't like buying vehicles on installment. Not only do I have to fit in the extra cost into my budgeting, such a bother to do that, but I'll also end up paying more than what the bike is really worth. I mean, for example, for a 400,000 peso bike, depending on what installment terms I opt for, I might end up paying a total of 700,000 pesos or even 800,000 pesos. So that's basically double the price of the bike. So no, thank you, I'd rather pay cash. Yeah. Too bad I didn't get to see the 400K, man, cause from the pictures it really looks like a great bike, and CF Moto might be a Chinese brand, Chinese motorcycle rather, but quality wise, performance wise, I've been hearing good things about it, about the brand, so I was really interested. Yeah, too bad, maybe next time. Yeah, well, that's it for now. Until next time, keep on riding on, baby.